What are your thoughts on the short-term rentals versus the long-term rentals? And do you have any short-term rentals? If you
I do
do,
not. Yeah, I do not have any short-term rentals. I think short-term rentals are amazing. I do think they are currently having their time in the sun. I believe that supply demand is undefeated. Right now, there was, if you look backwards the last couple of years, what was in most demand? Nobody wanted a hotel. They didn't like elevators. They would like to go, that they still want a vacation, so they were going to rent Airbnbs or VRBOs or whatever. Awesome. Great business. Now, what happens is people repeat what they've done my entire life is they start seeing people make money and they start getting into it, and then they start buying lower quality stuff and they start going farther away from, Airbnb used to be, it's the lake house. It's one street away. It's this, it's it had unique circumstances. And now it's like some bread and butter 1950s three bedroom one bath that, hasn't been updated since, whatever, the 80s. I think there are people overpaying. It's still working. If you have that property, that thing, go for it. I definitely recommend running Plan B. I do not think enough people have Plan B. What's a Plan B? Please, please run the numbers on your Airbnb purchases as month to month. Make that your worst case scenario. People are not doing that. If you buy it based on Airbnb numbers, and then the market changes or more supply comes on, and you got to discount 25% or 30%, or the city does this, and then your month-to-month rental makes it an alligator. If you know what an alligator is, it's in my book. It's not fun. You could be in trouble. So I think Airbnb and daily, nightly rentals, awesome. I do think too many people are not doing the work, frankly. They're buying a house, some know-nothing house. Oh, it's an Airbnb now. Really? It's kind of a busy street. It's got bars on the windows. You really think, people are going to like this? Yeah, I'm seeing some pretty crazy things right now in that space. Great idea. Can work, but I see some people getting kind of goofy with it.
I agree on that. And one of the other things that I see that also scares me with it is there's a lot of people that are creating courses around
Oh, yes.
rental arbitrage on Airbnb. Go lease like 10 different properties and rental arbitrage Airbnb. I'm like, I just feel like that's like the slow path to seeing a bunch of people lose everything. When so here's a real true story. One of our properties is in a historic area. It's now an Airbnb for us, but it has a guest house in the back and in the front house. There's a
Nice.
company that did this exact thing at the beginning of last
A
year.
big
A
company.
big company, like hundreds of employees company. And they leased our property and then they were doing the arbitrage model. And so they
Sure.
had hundreds, if not thousands, of properties they were doing this on. 2.5 weeks into COVID and the emergency lockdown situation, I got a call from executive, or might have even been the owner. I don't know. They had laid off most of their company, and he said, "We're not going to be able to make the rent payment next
You
month."
know things are bad when the CEO of the company is calling you to tell you the rent's not going to get paid.
It's not going to get paid. There's nothing for you to come after. You can try to sue us, but we're insolvent
Good
and
luck.
sorry. Literally, that's what he said. He's like, "You can keep the furniture."
No, that's, again, I've been doing this a long time. People are, they're predictable. The consumer, the person I've studied for 30 years, they move in a herd, right? The money's made being early. The money's made getting out of the way. Why did I sell all my properties in 2006? It's because I saw the idiots coming. Was I early? Yeah, I was early by 10%, but I got out of the way. I went from 8 to 80 units. I sat back and I'm like, damn it, I left 10% on the table. And then lo and behold, the next 5 years, I'm like, glad I got out of that stuff.
Oh, yeah.